It's television's biggest night.
Sam Rubin already in downtown L.A., where he will spend the rest of the day and night for the 70th Primetime Emmy Award. Sammy, good morning.
Frank and Jess, good morning. Both quick Los Angeles observation. We were here at this exact same spot last year, and those buildings above the Emmy sign, those three big ones, they weren't here. So the extraordinary explosion of residential development in downtown. The other explosion, Megan told you about it a little earlier this hour, the fight between Tom Arnold and Mark Burnett, really, really something. And of course, who purportedly witnessed the whole thing? It is 6 degrees of separation from Kevin Bacon. Kevin allegedly there, Allison Hannigan, the actress there, and Tom Arnold overnight with this tweet about Kevin Bacon, suggesting that Kevin is a reliable witness. And that also his daughter is a reliable witness. So we are making efforts to track down any and all of these people to bring you more about this. Will this be a topic of conversation on the Emmy red carpet? I think, frankly, it will. Will Michael Che and Colin Jost make a joke about it tonight? I think that's of interest because obviously it's a big story in L.A. Does it permeate enough around the country that they can make reference to it tonight? All right, one non-Emmy related item. Emily Blunt, of course, the movie actress, is playing Mary Poppins. I think people have mixed feelings about this. You know, do you dare mess with Mary Poppins? Brand new trailer literally just dropped for that Mary Poppins movie coming out at the end of the year. Look at this.
I live and breathe.
I was flying the kite and I got caught on a nanny.
Mary.
Poppins, you came back.
You seem hardly to have aged at all.
Really? One never discusses a woman's age, Michael. Would have hoped I'd taught you better.
What brings you here after all this time?
Same thing that brought me the first time. I've come to look after the bank's children.
Us?
Oh, yes, you too.
We're about to lose our home. Everything's fallen to pieces since your mother.
I miss Mother.
Nothing's gone forever, only out of place.
Good thing you come along when you did, Mary Poppins.
How'd you do that?
Do what?
Well, there, we've seen almost the entire thing. Of course, the Mary Poppins movie coming out in mid-December. Back to television, This Is Us nominated for Best Drama. Sterling K. Brown a nominee. Other stars of the show nominated as well. And tomorrow night, and this is smart, I think, NBC doing a big This Is Us special. There was a Paley Center event saluting This Is Us. They shot the whole thing. And for This Is Us fanatics, this is a special treat. Here, a sneak peek of a particular story that is well known in This Is Us lore. They were shooting in a residential neighborhood and found some people actually watching the show. Watch.
We're often shooting in neighborhoods. And we were shooting in a neighborhood, and through the window of a house across the street, Milo could see a family watching our television show live that same night.
So this family, if you can zoom in there, is actually watching our show. We're filming next door. We're gonna go knock on their door. Come on.
Hi. Sorry to bother you.
Hi.
We're filming next door, but we happen to notice what you're watching right now. You're watching us.
Yes, I'm watching you guys.
So we're
You get the feels already. NBC with a special This Is Us special the day after the Emmys. Does This Is Us walk away with any Emmys tonight? I think that is an open question. Probably Sterling K. Brown has the best chance to repeat as an Emmy winner. We know KTLA's Emmy coverage is award-winning, and we know that Megan and Jessica are the fashion icons of the world. Yesterday at a rehearsal, Jessica very casually dressed. I posted a picture of it. Megan dressed like a spy. What
like
will they wear tonight? Here, she was. Megan was dressed like a spy.
Trench coat?
She
what really does
was.
That mean?
Was very strange.
And
she
a briefcase.
Was,
it
she was
very.
Was,
she, no.
She was. She had big sunglasses, kind of a weird hidden bun, and then like a trench coat. In any event, what will Jessica and Megan wear tonight? The world wants to know, and we have a sneak peek. Look.
Stylist Anya Saar toasts
Tis the season.
You're almost giddy. And I've always wanted you to wear Kevin Hall. Oh.
To deck the Emmys with Kevin Hall haute couture, that is.
Vanessa Williams, Michelle Obama, but just tons and tons of beautiful women.
A rainbow of beautiful to try on.
So this one is...
Oh, I love that.
Right? The beautiful. Lilac Vision. Now, I see you eyeing this.
It's funny, I am always drawn to yellow. And I don't know why. Into the blues?
Into the blues.
Wow.
That says Emmys.
That is pretty.
But to find that pot of gold kind of gown, the award-winning designer points to fit. My turn to take a zip.
So maybe we'll do something like, you know, maybe not quite pink, more, that's why I say more rouge, antique-y pink.
Also loving the chic chiffon and streamlined silhouettes.
Goddess is what we think.
Oh, I love a good red dress.
Now you see why the House of Hall has our vote.
Right.
How are you?
Good.
Oh, here we go. All right, so what will Jessica and Megan wear? We'll find out. By the way, TV's Dana Devon in athleisure wear now, but I've seen this taken off. This is really
what?
Something.
Right. It'll be revealed.
It is hey, not in
you've
something
seen it
right
taken
now.
Off.
I got here like 5 hours early because I was so nervous about getting in because right. Usually I go show my badge and they're like, no, lady. Right. So I got here a little bit early, but I'll be taking over after yeah. You're done and we'll be broadcasting all the way from 9 to noon.
There we go.
Yeah.
So anyway, no, wait till you see this revealed. It's really something. KTLA's coverage all morning long, all midday sense. Long, and then the
I
live show is from 2 to 5, 3 hours of this. Say again, Jess?
Well, we're just confused. You said you've seen it without the thing on.
I'm explaining
and
to Frank what you
saying,
meant.
What is Sam okay. saying?
I think she takes off the jacket.
Very confusing.
All right, so here, let me explain.
Okay.
Dana's, here, stand in model pose if you don't mind. Dana, very good. Dana's wearing a dress from head to toe. But we are covering the top of the dress
yes.
with this athleisure.
She has been
very
working on the runway.
She's good at it.
Look at that.
She's worked.
She does
you've
that
done that before.
At home She's every night.
In front of the mirror.
But
nailed it.
After nine, this will come off. And I think, frankly, that could be the highlight of the whole morning. This will be my,
we look forward to it.
So there
yeah.
we go.
Thank you, Sam.
All
yes. I know is in the dress package that we just showed you, Mark goes, I hope you didn't pick that one. That might have been the one I picked.
Oh, no.
But you know what? It always goes that way, and that's okay.
Yeah.
And then you also,
I only said, I hope you didn't pick that one just to one of them.
And then he also said, are you pregnant?
No, I did not say
that. That's the combo.
Yeah, that's the combo.
That was the one
right
you
there. Two worst things you can say to a woman.
Yeah.
Yeah.
Yeah. And
but you know what? It's
also, are those hair extensions you're wearing?
Right. Or have you gained a little weight?
Yeah.
I've heard them all from you guys.
You've heard them all. Are you going to put in the extensions today?
Well.
Speaking of.
Don't reveal the secrets to all the viewers.
Okay.
Wait a minute. I actually think I have
something. Let's see. What
you got your hair?
This is like Mary Poppins.
Oh.
She's got the umbrella in there.
Where's your hair, Jess?
Yeah.
There's a bag of hair in
somewhere.
One of my bags today. Not this one.
Okay.
So thanks for asking.
All righty. I'm just out here looking out for you.
Oh, my.